called this concert. I've got to just remember what I called it. I've called this concert Remembrances and Rites of Passage. And this is something that's close to my heart in many ways. I've always worked with children, and I'll say a little bit more about the Rites of Passage elements when I play Joshua's Fire, which is my piece, later on. But I'm going to start with a little selection of Bach inventions. These are often considered some of Bach's simplest pieces, and we often associate them with children playing. But I think all of Bach is in these little miniatures. The technique that you need in order to play them beautifully is the technique that you need to play any of the bigger pieces of Bach, albeit perhaps you might need more time for the longer pieces. So I've chosen six little miniature gems, which I'm going to share with you first in the program. Thank you. continue the programme with Mozart's 12 variations on Ave, Dirai Je, Maman, which in English we know as the nursery rhyme Twinkle, Twinkle, Little Star. Now, there's been speculation as to whether Mozart actually composed the melody for this, but according to various sources, including Wikipedia, if you want to check, it's a mid-18th century anonymous tune, which originally was an adult song about a lover explaining the torment about his loving relationship. It was then turned into a nursery rhyme. It was given different words. And even as a nursery rhyme, the words are slightly strange. It's something along the lines of, "Ah, mummy, would you like to know what's tormenting me? It's that daddy wants me to reason like a big person, and actually I'm more interested in sweets." And it's a piece of music that Mozart, unlike many of the pieces that he composed as a child himself, he actually wrote when he was 25 years of age. And so it's quite a mature piece, and there's a lot of Mozart, a lot of opera and symphonic music in this delightful little set of variations. And I would encourage you to look up other variations by Mozart, because he was a master of this form.
Thank you.
Somehow associated with childhood to reflections, reminiscences of childhood. Schumann's Scenes of Childhood is not to be confused with the album For the Young, which was intended for children to play as a pedagogical work. The Scenes of Childhood is very much an adult reflecting back on childhood scenes, and some of the titles are really intriguing and quite abstract. So even the first little piece of Foreign Lands and It's an incredibly subtle, a typical of Schumann, incredibly subtle moods that he creates. And I found not always easy to interpret. And then there's the second one, a strange story. And we can only begin to imagine what that kind of, what that might have evoked for Schumann. A lot of the ones later on are even more abstract. There's frightening, and there's almost too serious. So I hope that you'll enjoy this romp through Schumann's reminiscences from an adult perspective.
Thank you. Thank you.
little bit about the final item in tonight's programme, I'd just like to say that there is a link in the description of this concert. If you wish to make a donation, however small or large, to Help Musicians UK, which is a wonderful charity. It's been established for 100 years and it helps musicians in all kinds of circumstances. And I'm sure you'll appreciate just how much that means to a lot of people at this particular moment in time when we're only just opening up the world of concerts and music making again. So please do make a donation if you wish. The link's in the description. So I'm going to finish this concert with my own Joshua's Fire. And this really brings the whole programme to a full circle, if you like, because with some irony, I realised that my own experience of being in a music school and practising for many hours a day, especially in particular ways, really made me feel like I'd left parts of my own life behind. And it wasn't until I was in my mid-30s that I really reconnected, or connected perhaps for the first time, with my own voice as a person and as a composer. And so these pieces really were the first that I'd ever written that I feel embody my own piano voice, my own compositional style. And I wrote them in 2015, and I'm not quite sure how I did it now, but I made some videos of which I'm very proud, which you can watch on my YouTube channel if you like, which is youtube.com/ Stephen Marquiss Piano. I think we're going to sprinkle in a few clips from those YouTube videos if the technology works. Fingers crossed. It's really a rite of passage, this music. It starts with the gate of Janus, and I'm sure many of you know that Janus was a god with a face facing forwards and one facing backwards. And I was very fortunate to be allowed to quote from a lovely poem by Joyce Supfen called Crossroads. And I really felt that this was a moment that was a crossroads for me. And the quotation that's on the video for this music is, "The second half of my life will be black to the white rind of the fading moon." So it's about noticing, really, that something's up. And you'll probably hear in the middle of the piece, which is very short, a bell tolling, signifying that something's in the air, something needs to change, can't carry on like this. And then following a period of realization, it's often the case that we experience a kind of euphoria. And so the second one's called A New Eden, where everything seems just right, everything's got its place, all is right with the world. And as I'm sure you'll be aware, very often following A New Eden is a low point, a very low point. And the third piece is called The Dark Night, La Noche Oscura. And it's the only one that really sort of straddles the avant-garde. There's a little bit of avant-garde jazz, perhaps, about it, but don't let that put you off. It's still very melodic. Number four, Whence Cometh the East Wind, is again a reconnection with change, knowing that change is in the air. Before a moment of clarity, which is number five, A Hill Called Clear, which is a quotation from the wonderful Pilgrim's Progress. And the last two, the penultimate piece is called Jordan, and that refers to the river, not the country. And the last one is In Peace. And if you do happen to want to watch the videos on my YouTube channel at some point, I do recommend that you watch to the end of the final piece, because the depiction of In Peace pictorially in images is perhaps not what you might expect. So this is Joshua's Fire. And I'd just like to say thank you very, very much to my dear friend Julian, who's produced this concert and set it all up for us. I'd like to thank you for tuning in and sharing this moment with me. And if you have any questions, about Joshua's Fire or about anything else, then please do get in touch via the chat feature of the live stream, and I'll be able to answer a few questions afterwards if you like. Thank you very much for coming and watching.
Thank you.
again for coming to this concert. I hope you've enjoyed the music. I'm going to glance over to my partner in crime over there, who seems to be indicating that somebody has made a comment or left a question. So.
Stephen Bravo loved all of it, and your way of pitching him in felt stress-free. My question is, did you feel even freer whilst playing your own composition? Was there a qualitative difference for you?
Yes, but I think that's partly because... thank you for your question, Lee, by the way. I think that's partly because it was near the end. It's an interesting thing, performing for the first time in over a year, with one tiny exception, where I just played a little cameo on a webinar. I really haven't performed in over a year, as is the case with many musicians who haven't done online streaming. This is my first online streaming gig. So, yeah, I think a lot about the process that sports people and anybody who does something that involves great deal of concentration, you know, what does that process involve? So, I think for most of us, there's still always something to learn. But yeah, I do feel a particular affinity with Joshua's Fire because of that kind of personal connection that I hinted at earlier. Thank you very much indeed for your question. I really appreciate it. Have we got anything else from the floor, so to speak? Well, thank you, Julian, and thank you again very much for coming. And please do subscribe to the St Pancras Clock Tower YouTube channel if you'd like to hear more about events that are going on here and get notifications of future concerts. And I wish you good night, and